front brake pads on the Mark V Seat Ibiza. This will probably be the same as the VW Polo and Skoda Fabia. I like to place the car in full lock towards the side that you're working on. Open up the brake fluid reservoir and check the level prior to starting, because you'll be pushing the piston back in and you want to make sure that it doesn't overflow, and if it's above the maximum you'll need to extract some. Pop off these two plastic grommets on the back of the caliper, and these uncover a 7mm hex. Clean these up with a wire brush, and when refitting, place some normal lithium grease on the contact surface. I found a bit of a cheat for resetting the piston. If you stick a screwdriver in and push the path back, if you aren't changing the discs, try not to pry against the disc, so you'll want to pry off the edge of the disc rather than this way, which would push against the disc and possibly damage and score the disc. If the fluid level is close to the top, then make sure that you check it before resetting the piston fully. So now we've done that, we won't need to worry about resetting it with a rewind tool or a G-clamp you can use. I've not seen this before, but the calipers sort of lock in at the bottom with this protrusion here, so you have to pull the top out first. Hang the caliper out of the way on the strut. Now, on a lot of cars, if you are replacing the discs, you'll need to remove the caliper carrier as well. But on this, fortunately, the caliper carrier only comes up to here. So to remove the disc, all we need to do is remove this T30 Torx screw. And to lock the disc in position, you can just stick a screwdriver in the vent. Now, if you were replacing the disc, clean up the hub and make sure there's no debris on the new disc when refitting. Now, because we're not changing the discs, what we need to do is knock the rust off the edge of the disc on both sides. If you are just changing the pads, you don't need to remove the disc, but it is good to check this inside edge here, as quite often you can't see it from the outside and this can corrode quite badly and cause issues with the braking. Otherwise, make sure that the surface is clear. If you want to apply some copper grease, that's fine, just a little bit. And fit the new disc or old disc. No need to over tighten these, they're only there to hold the disc in position while the wheel is refitted. The wheel bolts will centralise and hold the disc in position naturally. Clean off any contact surfaces, so got the caliper carrier where the pads meet. Got the piston and the outer pad mating surface. So any mating surfaces should be coated with a little bit of copper grease. That includes where the clips go into the piston. So we've got three contact points for them. Got this area here, which is what locks the caliper to the carrier. And then we've got the carrier itself, where the pads need to slide on. Of course, be careful not to get this on the brake disc or the pads. But if you do, clean it off with brake cleaner. So I've got some Brembo pads for this car. They are different. So the larger clip goes on the piston side and the smaller clip goes on the outer side of the caliper. With some pads you can struggle to get them in, so what you need to do is push one clip in and then push the pad to the side and then push it into position. And now if the piston is fully pushed in, make sure that you get the brake hose not twisted. It's easy to get them twisted when you've been moving them around. You should be able to push the caliper back over the disc. These bolts don't need to be overly tight. Replace the caps. And now, before you do anything else, pump the brake pedal. Now this is not only to get an accurate reading on the reservoir. The first time you use the brakes after doing the pads and discs, it quite often won't work. And if you forget and drive off and you won't have any brakes, If you need to extract any fluid, then extract it before replacing the cap. But otherwise, that's job done.